for three for the Indiana Hoosiers, and this one by far the most difficult. The 22nd ranked team in the country, the SMU Mustangs, coming on the American Athletic Conference. They're going to take on Tom Crean's Indiana Hoosiers, and Larry Brown is going to be a star all evening long. This is a guy who's still going at it. He's been coaching everywhere, 9 different NBA teams, now in his third season with the SMU Mustangs. Let's check out tonight's Buffalo Wild Wings starting lineups. First, the visitors from SMU. They start 2 Indiana natives, Nick Moore from Winona Lake, and Justin Martin, his first season with SMU, the transfer from Xavier. He went to Lawrence North High School in Indianapolis. Jim Jackson for Indiana. Same starting 5 through the first 3 games.
Very important when Hanna Mascara-Perea, that he had 5 blocks last game. The scouting reporter is going to say that he stay on his feet. He can't afford to get in early foul trouble if you're the Indiana Hoosiers.
Well, Tom Crean says this team a work in progress. 2 impressive wins so far this season, but both against SWAC teams. This is a big-time step up, taking on the SMU Mustangs, who did lose a game earlier this week, but are really highly regarded, ranked 22nd to begin the season, and that's right about where Larry Brown thought his team would be. And he returned to the college game, taking one last chance just to see if he could rekindle the magic that won him a national championship in Kansas in 1988 with Danny and the Miracles. This is a guy that you played for, Jim Jackson.
A pure love of the game. I mean, you think about it, older in age, but wiser, smarter, understanding how to take what he's learned in the NBA and past college experiences and passing that on to these young men. The enthusiasm is there. It's a little bit different, but being the professional he is, Eric, he's been able to adjust, and it's paying dividends for this SMU program.
You just saw it on your screen. A little bit of a surprise. SMU leads the all-time series 2-1. The most recent game was won by Indiana. That was 1977. Mike Woodson was the game's leading scorer. SMU, they beat Lamar, and they've lost on the road against Gonzaga. And that was back on Monday. And the tap is 1 by Indiana.
And Eric, that loss to Gonzaga was a tough loss because they didn't really compete, SMU. So that could be a good or bad thing for Indiana coming into this evening's game, because they have a lot to prove to themselves.
Farrell, Blackman, Johnson, Mascara-Perea, and Zeisloff, the 5 on the floor to begin the game for Indiana. And a turnover right out of the chute. That's not what Tom Crean wanted to see.
But interesting to see the 2 freshmen, Johnson and Blackman, handling the basketball up front, Yogi Ferrer in the corner. That allows Yogi to be a little freer in exploiting the defense. So let's keep an eye on that as well.
Ben Moore, Chicago kid out of Bolingbrook, southwest suburb. It's actually 2 Illinois natives starting for SMU. Also in the starting lineup, Sterling Brown. He wears number 3. He is from Chicago's west side. Little floater off the mark, missed by Moore, but he got his own rebound back. Just 5'9", but he's a dynamo. Martin out of control, offensive foul.
Excellent play that time by Perea. By sliding over, again, not staying married to his position in the zone, but the first possession I thought was key for SMU because they were able to attack Indiana in the zone, get a shot, get the offensive rebound. Indiana has to tighten that up a little bit more. They want to continue to play zone against this SMU team.
Here comes Farrell off the screen, working along that wing. Toss to Blackman, leading freshman scorer in the country, and he misses from deep. Blackman averaging 22 points per game, but through 2 games, just 2 assists. We'll see if that changes as the Hoosiers get closer to full strength.
Eric,
3 guys playing today that haven't played all season.
I'm going to score. He said, I'm going to leave the pass into Yogi and to Johnson on the perimeter. But he can pass the basketball. But right now, he's had some great looks early on in the first 2 games, and he's responded well.
Ben Moore got out of trouble and flips it up and in. First 2 go to the Mustangs. Johnson over to Farrell. Open look. Just can't give him that.
dribble penetration. We saw that shoot around. One thing that Tom Crean spoke to his guys about was turning the corner, getting in the lane, and then making the extra pass.
Yeah, everyone's curious as to the hot shooting for Indiana. First two games of the year, can they keep it up against a longer and better club in the SMU Mustangs? Moore. Rebound run down in the corner by Yannick Moreira. Moreira is a guy highly thought of, 6'11 center from Angola. Moore with a nice half hook, comes up empty. Moreira loses it out of bounds. Last touch by Indiana.
I talked about Yogi Ferrer off the ball, and right here, excellent penetration by Johnson. And then, again, as soon as he feels a little help, kicks it over to Yogi Ferrer, who's able to catch in rhythm instead of initiating offense. Now he's being the recipient of a lot of those passes.
Offensive foul. Too aggressive was Nick Moore. Trying to work against his former AAU teammate, Yogi Ferrell.
Well, it's not a coincidence that Indiana has been able to pick up two charges. They work on this every day in practice. You slide your feet, you beat your opponent to the spot, and then you hold your ground.
It's going to be critical for Nick Moore to play with some composure. This is an important game for him.
Well, it is mentally, but he has to stay within the moment. Don't make it bigger than what it has to be.
Johnson gets a screen, the lead for Blackman. Johnson gets it back, fading to the left on that jumper, and it rattles out. SMU basketball. Johnson had made four of his first 6 3-pointers coming into tonight's game.
Good shot. In rhythm, he caught it. It was in and out. You'll take that shot any day of the week if you're Tom Crean.
Nick Moore was the runner-up in 2011 for the Indiana Mr. Basketball. That year, Cody Zeller taking home the hardware. Patient move. Wow, there's something real good going on there with Moreira.
Size advantage, SMU.
One and done. Martin with the rebound in traffic.
And I think that's why you see early on zone defense by Indiana.
Martin step-in jumper. And again, some pushing going on in the paint. That foul's going to be on Nick Zeisler.
Last year, this SMU team, for those who don't know, averaged 11, throwing to 12 points in second chance points. They're long, they're athletic, but they're in good position to be able to get an offensive rebound. The challenge for Indiana with the smaller lineup is getting a body and getting those big bodies away from the basket.
Extra pass. This is Brown. Farrell goes baseline. Open look, Zeisler. Nick Moore. And now the Mustangs will reset. Moreira leaves it low and picked away. On the baseline was Mascara Perea, so it's going to be SMU basketball.
That time, a little congestion on the baseline. If Brown hadn't gone all the way through, Moreira would have had an easy way to the basket.
Ball poked away by Farrell. Leads to a run out. And Blackman, so crafty, gets it to go. No fear.
If you look at James Blackman, you say, well, he doesn't look that athletic. But I tell you, he can get up. He can explode. And that time, no fear at all. Put that little left shoulder right in the chest of Moreira. And took away the ability for him to use his length trying or attempting to block the shot.
Pass goes off the knee of Mascara Perea. Shot clock does not reset. Mustangs will have to hurry. Moore left open. Nice soft touch. Moore from Warsaw High School, up by Winona Lake, Indiana, North Central Indiana. Same high school that produced Rick Fox, longtime NBAer.
I was outstanding pacers that time. Didn't let the shot clock winding down speed up the pace of the offense for SMU.
We played 5 minutes in Indiana trailing the Mustangs by a pair. Oh, a rare jump shot. Mascara Perea would never have taken that shot his first 2 years. You can see the confidence evolving for the junior. Timeout on the floor. James Blackman, he's not afraid. Look at the freshman, just 19 years of age, attacking the big man and getting some results. Ball on BTN is presented by April Air. Feel good inside. And brought to you in part by State Farm. It pays to double check. Talk to your agent today. And by Country Mart. Get more per gallon. So much history when you think about Indiana basketball over the years, but a new day. A couple of freshmen putting up big-time numbers.
Big-time numbers, big-time players. What a relief if you're Yogi Ferrell, because it takes the pressure off you. One, trying to score everything in the backcourt. Two, handle the basketball. But they give you options, in particular when teams want to play zone against Indiana. Now you can spread the floor. Hanna Mascara-Perea inside can start to develop his inside game, knowing you have shooters around the perimeter.
Blackman and Johnson combined average 40 points a game. If you add in Max Hotzel, that's 50 points a night by freshman. Good rip away. That's Cannon Cunningham into the game for the first time. Mustangs have the ball and the lead. Two turnovers now for Indiana.
A good deed that time, but it was a poor passing angle in which Robert Johnson tried to get the ball to the post.
Left the wrong man open. Nick Morkin hit that shot.
You think he settled in a little bit there?
Six early points.
You think he settled
for
in
Nick
right
Moore.
Now.
Began his college career at Illinois State. And decided he wanted to play for a legend. Now in his second season with SMU. Indiana still playing with their starting five that began the game. That's a lot of three-pointers taken early. Six of the eight shots taken by Indiana have been from behind the arc.
And where subconsciously, when you don't have a go-to like you have right here with SMU post, the tendency is to stay on the perimeter or to overdrive. That's something that this coaching staff is going to have to massage as the season continues to go on.
Now Tom Crean calling a timeout. Doesn't like the way this one is heading. It is a 12-5 lead for the visitors from Dallas. Welcome back. 13:46 remaining here in our first half. SMU on top of Indiana. Hoosiers off to a cold shooting start. This is atypical of what we've seen so far this year here at Assembly Hall. Yogi Ferrell and the guys red hot in their first two games.
Wow. Indiana had some good shots, but keep in mind, this is a different SMU team that's from, you know, Texas Southern. Bigger, more athletic, and to force you to shoot over the top. I'm sure that Indiana will make an adjustment, but it is a little tough early going.
That was our State Farm State of Success blistering shooting for Indiana. This roster has been remade. There's a lot more jump shooters or high percentage shooters than in years past.
Well, keep in mind, too, Troy Williams, Stanford Robson, they give you another dimension. Guys who love to get to the basket, that move well without the ball. Yet to be integrated, but, you know, we have to keep that in mind as we're watching this early on.
Colin Hartman, the first sub in off the bench for Indiana. He wears number 30. Shot clock down to two. Johnson has to fire. He was hit, no call. And it's going to be SMU basketball. Moore always pushing. Martin, the lead for Cunningham. This is a good start for the Mustangs.
Well, the problem is, watching IU practice, they wanted to push the pick and roll down to the baseline. That time, not able to do so. Now, you have an empty side, open jump shot, easy shot for SMU.
At the scorer's table, Troy Williams. There's a bucket for James Blackman, a three-pointer. And we'll have a whistle in our first time this year, Troy Williams on the floor.
Athleticism, size. Again, he can't be too excited coming into the game, but it gives you another dimension, another player that can compete on the interior from a rebounding perspective for Indiana.
That's pretty cool. You heard that round of applause for Troy Williams, who was a good performer as a freshman, suspended for the first three games. Great hang time. Ben Moore gets it to go. 4 points now for the sophomore.
But the ball is moving around too easy. They're able to penetrate the zone.
Ferrell. Hartman, the offensive rebound. Hartman, Mustangs love to run. They're always pushing that basketball. And Moore lost his footing. He'll be called for the travel. SMU doubling their pleasure on the road. They've got a 16-8 lead over the Hoosiers. Indiana by a score of 16-8. Jim Jackson, what have you noticed so far?
Attention to detail. In shoot-around, the theme for Tom Crean was to be able to push the pick and roll down to the baseline. Colin Hartman has to get up on the high side. Mascara Pereira on the inside, forcing the ball for that. Now, when you run the play, Hartman doesn't get there. So now you have an open side and an easy shot once the pass gets there. No one can rotate over. Mm. So communication from Pereira early, but Hartman has to jump up a little bit to force that screen and roll down to the baseline.
A lot of early minutes for Hunter Mascara Pereira. He's trying to figure out what it's like to play extended minutes. He was a guy who would just play for 2 or 3 minute spurts his first 2 years, but expectations have totally changed here in 2014. Troy Williams gets inside. SMU basketball.
Well, out of the timeout, a drawn up play to Troy Williams, and Coach Crean is telling him, you get to the basket a little bit more. But I like the fact they tried to get him in early to kind of settle him down a little bit. This is the end of the court right here, Eric, where Indiana has to make a stand. One shot, rebound, and get out and go.
SMU brings in Keith Frazier, number 4. Sophomore, McDonald's All-American out of Dallas. Pretty nice luxury to hold a McDonald's All-American on the bench for the first 8 minutes of the game. Here's Frazier. Long two-pointer.
Wow.
This talented player.
But with the short shorts.
I love it. He's got a good look.
But here's the thing. Did you notice Indiana players, their hands were down to the side? So you can make those type of passes without anyone stopping it. You have to be active.
Frazier showing you a little bit of what he can do. Makes the jumper. And then the nice running layup.
The ability to get a stop and get out in transition, one pass up the court, when you have athletes that SMU have, you have to be well balanced in the backcourt once that shot goes up if you're Indiana.
SMU making a commitment to the basketball program with Larry Brown on that sideline. Finally, something goes down. First two of the year for Troy Williams.
Take a look. Hands have to be active. Right now, you go to a man-to-man. You can't let free reign. The easy passes, right there, penetrating passes.
And that'll be a chance for a three-point play. Ben Moore makes the layup, and he'll go to the free throw line. And 6 points for Moore.
Well, part of that, Eric, is that Yogi Ferrell, no pressure on the basketball. So that's an easy interior pass inside. And when Troy Williams is beat by a half a second, you depend on your teammate to add some pressure. So maybe that pass won't get there in time. But right now, Indiana, from a defensive perspective, you don't see a lot of energy right now in the defensive end.
Stanford Robinson has just checked in. His first playing time of the year. Like Troy Williams, he missed the first 4 games, 2 of them being exhibition games, with a suspension. Moore can't finish off the 3-point play, but the lead is 12 for SMU. Farrell. That's how you get back in the game. Second 3-pointer made by Yogi Farrell. Benny Melagu is into the game for SMU. And what do we have? This is going to be a foul going against SMU. Now it's an illegal screen set by Ben Moore. Another substitution for SMU. Ryan Manuel checks in the game. He wears number 1. Bigger point guard for the Mustangs.
Yeah, long athletic.
Long two-pointer by Williams. One and done. Rebounded by Frazier. Here's Manuel. And Robinson, nice overplay, almost a steal.
Robinson fighting off a little bit of a cut on the upper lip. Got that bandage there.
Oh, excellent movement right here. Didn't stay stagnant in the post. Now, Robinson has given up, you know, a few inches to Cunningham. So you can't allow him to get deep-rooted in the post. Once he gets the ball in there, if he's too deep, there's nothing that Robinson can do about it except hope for the other team.
Good active hands by Williams. Gets the steal. Now he wants to run. Six turnovers for SMU.
Active hands. Coaches talk about deflections all the time. Sanford Robinson able to get his hands in there. You see the difference when you have a Troy Williams in the game, the kind of energy that he's bringing, not only offensively, but on the defensive end with Robinson as well.
Yogi Ferrell goes to the bench. Back into the game, James Blackman. Quick move. Robinson blocked away by Cunningham. Tough catch in traffic. Nick Moore uses a little bit of a chicken wing to get some shooting room, and he comes up empty. Something to keep your eye on. The guy with the ball right here, Robinson, he was a left-handed jump shooter a year ago. Zeiss locked. Frazier fouls him, and Zeisloft, chance for four.
Well, it's a cross-court pass. Ideally, you want the ball to go to Robert Johnson, then to Zeisloft in the corner. You can rotate him. When you can make that direct pass, the rotation is not there. Keep in mind, Eric, as you know, it's a game of runs, okay? SMU gets out to a hot start. Indiana trying to find his way. Indiana get a couple stops, make some baskets. The crowd gets into it. Now you're back in the game. So you're never out of it early. You just have to keep it in striking distance, settle in, get yourself back involved in the game.
And an offensive foul on Cunningham, an illegal screen.
A little weave action right here, and Cunningham has to be a little bit smarter with using the body, the shoulder, edging out a little bit. If you can't get the screen, just let it go.
Troy Williams will get a blow. Mascara Perea back on the floor for Indiana. Looks like Johnson will be the main ball handler with Farrell on the bench. Hands it off to Stanford Robinson. To finish off the thought, Stanford Robinson shooting jumpers right-handed this year. He was a left-handed player a year ago. And what do we have? We've got a foul called on SMU. It's Stanford Robinson who was grabbed. 7:50 remaining in our first half. Zeisloff electrifying the crowd here in Bloomington. Wall-to-wall basketball. How about this? Tomorrow night, Brandon Dawson and the Michigan State Spartans taking on Loyola. The Ramblers out of Chicago. Coverage starts at 7 Eastern, presented by April Air on BTN and BTN to go. With my partner Jim Jackson, I'm Eric Collins. We're going to have a free throw situation right now for Stanford Robinson, the sophomore out of Landover, Maryland. Last year, he was an exclusively left-handed jump shooter and left-handed free thrower. This year, he said, you know what? I'm going to try my right hand. It was actually a suggestion by Will Sheehy, who was on last year's team and has moved on to playing professionally over in Europe. But he said, you know what? Maybe you're actually a right-handed shooter. So he tried it, and he's going to do it. So here's going to be the first right-handed free throw for Stanford Robinson.
Conceptually, I understand. Will it work? We don't know. But give credit to Stanford for not locking in. He understood he had a problem, shot in the 60s last year as far as free throw percentage, and he knew he had to be better. So it's yet to see where this worked, but I'm not mad at him for trying. And it looks good.
Didn't get the roll.
Didn't make it.
He actually dribbled it with his left hand.
And put it in his right. It's amazing how, from a mental perspective as basketball players, when something doesn't go right, it can He's a pretty good shooter. You would think that he could shoot free throws at a higher clip, you know, mid to low 70s, but he doesn't. So it becomes mental after a while.
Frazier, the whip-in pass to Cunningham, who cashes in. Cunningham now with four off the bench for SMU.
And you see some of the talent of Frazier, how he touted prospect 2 years ago coming out of the Dallas area. Can shoot it, can pass it, long, athletic.
Blackman, step in three. 8 points early for the freshman. Cunningham finds his man Brown inside, and a whistle and a foul. Sterling Brown to the free throw line.
Excellent interior passing right here as Frazier comes off the pick. Now the zone or the defense opens up in the middle, and watch the hands of the Indiana players. You're down by your side. So you can't get a deflection. You don't force maybe an off-center pass. And that's what I'm talking about, activity. And Tom Crean teaches his guys all the time, how many deflections, can we get within the game? Because you may not get the steal, Eric, but you may prevent a play like that from taking place.
Tom Crean bringing Yogi Ferrell and Troy Williams back into the game. Also checking in for the first time, Max Hotzel. Haven't seen Hotzel. Freshman out of Calabasas, California. Another free throw for Sterling Brown. He's the younger brother of former Michigan State Spartan Shannon Brown. Here comes Indiana down by five. Hotzel, quick trigger. And the Mustangs lose it out of bounds. Max Hotzel has played for the German national team in the under 18 division. Dual citizenship, United States and Germany.
Not shy. Came right in and put it up.
Farrell gets inside, had it blocked away, and got it back and threw it away. So a missed shot and a turnover. How quick are these Mustangs getting on the floor? Moreira now with four.
Well, what you like about it, Eric, is that when somebody's open, the ball immediately gets there.
Johnson, contested shot. Manuel didn't expect the pass. Somehow gets it back. And that foul saved a deuce. There's a foul call. And that saved a basket. There were two Mustangs open wide underneath the basket.
Well, talking to Larry Brown before the game, and you see the scrum right here. Guys, understanding how valuable this possession is. But the challenge with the team is not the athletic part of it. It's plays like this. You know, he said they go through the shell drill. That's basically five on nothing when you're walking through practice. And they still make some of those same mistakes that we just saw. And that's against no defense.
Mm-hmm.
That's the challenge for this SMU team.
Frazier. Good save getting on the floor, the freshman Johnson. And Farrell is grabbed. Foul on Sterling Brown.
Well, Manuel and Brown were in great position that time. They stopped the penetration, but right at the end, the reach down caused the foul.
Yogi Ferrell, 82% from the free throw line a season ago. 4-for-6 early in this campaign. And more so than any other place in the conference, there's not a lot of talk when a Hoosier shooting free throws here at Assembly Hall. Stay tuned at the half of the State Farm Halftime Report. Dave Revson, Stephen Bardo, breaking down our first half here in Bloomington. And we'll check out tonight's action around the rest of the conference. Close ones involving Penn State. Michigan was in a good one. They'll have more coming up at the half.
That statement you just made about being quiet kind of reminds me, being a golfer that I am. It's certain rules when you go to Augusta that you just adhere to people don't really have to tell you. They already know about it. Kind of similar to this.
Don't talk. Or the Hoosiers at the line. That's why Steve Alford never missed.
No, Steve Alford never misses. He's a heck of a shooter. That's why.
Ball stolen away. Indiana, chance to tie with a three. Blackman. It takes is a freshman to lead you, and James Blackman is just that freshman. 57 tie, 5:21 remaining here in our first half.
Eric, turnovers have been the difference to why Indiana has been able to get back, and you see the position here on the court with Yogi Ferrell playing in between. Excellent help defense, but also able to open up and not close his back to the basketball.
Nick Moore, quick trigger on a rebound inside by Blackman. Here come the Hoosiers flying down the floor, and a foul, a block on SMU.
A little strategy here by Coach Tom Crean during the timeout, came out in the zone, SMU not ready. Troy Williams able again to get out in transition. Manuel not in position to take the charge, but you love the attacking nature right now, because early in the game it was kind of SMU attacking Indiana. Back on their heels, took a lead. But I thought when Troy Williams, Stanford got in the game, the energy level changed. And I think the reason why, Eric, to be honest with you, to get back in good graces with the coaching staff and your teammates, what do? You play hard on the defensive end.
I also think it was a feel-good environment here at Assembly Hall when they both, Robinson and Williams, got such a nice round of applause when they entered the game their first time coming off the suspension.
Two free throws made by the sophomore Williams. And Indiana up by a pair. Look at that run, 19-5. Moore gets inside, hangs, and dips it in off the window.
Yeah, talked about it early on. You saw 8 points that he's averaging this year, but he averaged 13 and a half last year.
Oh, Blackman able to go right to the cup and had it knocked away. And Larry Brown telling everyone, it's our basketball. Still got good hands. He won a gold medal as a player in the 1964 Tokyo Olympics.
Well, I think people, because he's been so successful as a coach, don't really realize how good of a basketball player he actually was.
Loose on the floor, and another steal for Indiana. Yes. Holtzel picks it up.
Poor spacing that time by SMU.
Nine turnovers here in the first 16 minutes for SMU. The lead for Johnson. Chance for Moore. Ben Moore. Little floater over the outstretched arms of Williams. 8 points early for Moore.
Yeah, too easy. At that time, Troy Williams has to take the middle away.
How does Blackman get so open? That's lethal. 14 points for James Blackman.
It's the little things, Eric. You score on this end, lack of communication on the back end. You leave, which is perhaps Indiana's best shooter, who just hit a three, wide open.
Melogu. Bodies flying. What do we got? It is a foul on SMU. Timeout on the floor. SMU. They're in trouble right now. Larry Brown getting angry. Looking for some help. At one point, SMU leading 22-10 over Indiana, but that's all changed in large part because of James Blackman Jr.
14 points. He's 4-6 from behind the arc. But what you got to love about this young man is his poise. He may start off a little slow, but once he gets in attack mode, whether that's attacking the basket, spotting up for a three-point shot, He makes his presence felt. And what I love is his demeanor. He doesn't try to force the situation. And if you notice all of these shots, Eric, they're all within the realm of the offense. Not like a lot of other high-profile freshmen who try to just take it and beat you all the time. The reason why he's so efficient, he allows the game to come to him.
So far this season, he has made 10 out of 14 three-pointers. Came into this one 6 out of 8 from behind the arc. He's 4 out of 6 shooting triples so far this evening. Yogi Ferrell will shoot 2 free throws. Double bonus for Indiana.
And I'm sure Larry Brown, Coach Brown, talked to his team. Like, listen, we have 3 minutes and 20 seconds left before we go into half. What did we do well to establish ourselves? We took care of the basketball. We made excellent passes. Defensively, we were in good position. We need to get back to that to finish this half off strong so we can go into the locker room either tied or with the lead.
Yogi Ferrell joins James Blackman in double figures. He's got 10. Colin Hartman has checked in for the second time for Indiana. Interesting, SMU has played a large chunk of this first half without their 6'11 center, Yannick Morera, who's a stud.
Well, he had a big impact at the beginning of this game, so it's going to be interesting.
Ferrell knocks the pass out of bounds, 10 on the shot clock. Yeah, number 2, Yannick Morera, averaged 18 points in the FIBA World Cup this past summer. That's the same World Cup won by Derrick Rose, Kyrie Irving, and the Americans. 18 points, played for Angola. Here's Frazier, quick trigger. High arcing jumper. Offensive rebound, Moore! Ben Moore!
Two outstanding plays by Moore. Immediately when he got the ball at the free throw line, looked across court for a jump shot. But then he dove to the basket, didn't give up on the play, able to get the offensive rebound.
Hand off to Blackman. And a foul going for the rebound. It's going to be on Hartman.
Their coaches can live with a play like this. You're aggressive. You're trying to keep the offensive possession alive. For SMU, work for you. You're patient offensively. You move the basketball. You shifted Indiana's defense. And once you were able to do that, you found the little gaps that they found early on in the game.
SMU is playing a couple of men down. No Marcus Kennedy. This is a guy who is preseason All-American Athletic Conference. A big guy who's going to be out until second semester dealing with some academic issues. And also no Emmanuel Moody, man, this is a guy with a top 3 recruit in the country who decided to play in China instead of playing college basketball. Williams hits the deck hard. Troy Williams will shoot a pair.
Once again, deflections being active in the interior right here. A strip down by Johnson and Troy Williams right here. Excellent job of not trying to force the pass to Johnson on the wing. Not enough space. Head up, eyes up. And a tough foul right here. You know, fans may not like it. It's a tough foul, but Nick Moore ensured that Troy Williams wasn't able to get the ball up and possibly get in a position to have a three-point play.
Second foul for Nick Moore. He'll probably leave just to protect him with a minute 43 remaining in our first half. Williams hits the first. Stay tuned for news, highlights, and more on the State Farm Halftime Report. Dave Revson, Stephen Barno back at our Big Ten studios. They've already seen a lot of good hoops so far, a week and a half into the season. It's been fun. 6 points now for Troy Williams. Ryan Manuel replacing Nick Moore, running the point for SMU. Manuel along the baseline. Leave for Martin. And Williams called carrying the basketball.
That time a little over-anxious that time. Coach Tom Crean telling Williams on top of the ball. Attack. The coaches always talk about the last 2 to 3 minutes of a half. That can sway momentum. Right now in favor of Indiana, but if SMU gets a basket here, gets a stop, you still feel good about yourself if you can get your momentum back going into halftime.
Frazier throws up a knuckleball, one and done. Rebounded in traffic by Johnson. Indiana's only committed 3 turnovers. And what do we have? We have a foul, offensive foul on Johnson. Second foul.
So let's take a look and see in position. Cunningham. The fans may not like that. I think it's a pretty good call that time, because once Johnson left his feet early as he did, it allowed Cunningham to be in position to take the charge.
Johnson goes to the bench, replaced by Robinson. And Cunningham is fouled. It's called on Hunter Mosquera Perea. First foul on the junior from Columbia. So a free throw situation for Larry Brown's Mustangs.
Eric, and sometimes when things come easy early on, in the case of SMU, when they were able to get the ball inside, the tendency is to go away from it because it's too easy. The last couple of possessions, now you get the ball inside. Unfortunately, Cunningham missed, but you get the kind of shots and results that you want.
I'm still surprised. Only 7 first-half minutes for Yannick Morera, who had a couple of dunks inside early. Looked impressive. He's not in foul trouble. Shot clock off. Farrell. Rebounded inside, and what a first half. Troy Williams. A lot of pent-up energy for him. And a foul on Blackman with 6 ticks remaining.
Think Troy Williams was ready to play in this game tonight. I mean, he's all over the place, whether that's offensive rebound, on defense, in transition. That's the difference that you see when you have an athletic forward like a Troy Williams that can compete with the size and athleticism with an SMU. Number 2,
Zeislav. Zeislav comes in just in case there's a last second heave here. 6.1 remaining in the first half. Justin Martin. We'll shoot a 1-and-1. And a lane violation. Missed opportunity for SMU.
The mental errors. That's what I'm talking about. The mental errors plague this SMU team. And give credit to Indiana, because when they make a mental error, Indiana is able to capitalize off of it.
Let's see what the Hoosiers have up their sleeve. Farrell, top of the key. And the basket is waved off. No basket. The Hoosiers up by 5 at the break. We've played 20 minutes here at Assembly Hall in Bloomington, Indiana. The Hoosiers, a slow start, but they figured things out. The 4-point play by Zeislav, a big reason why they've got a halftime lead of 5 here against SMU. Back, everyone. Assembly Hall here in Bloomington. So much history in this building. It is a 5-point lead for the Indiana Hoosiers on top of the 22nd-ranked team in the country. With Jim Jackson, I'm Eric Collins. It was real nice to see Troy Williams back and play well.
It was interesting because when he entered the game, the energy in the building picked up. Because I think the fans were happy to see him back in there. And it was his activity, I thought, that spread to his teammates. Whether it's deflection, get out in transition, defensively you're talking. And sometimes a spark can come from out of nowhere. But I do think Troy Williams had something to prove, not only to himself, but to his teammates and coaching staff, that he was ready to play.
2 of 4 from the field, 4 of 4 from the free throw line, 8 points, 3 rebounds. For the sophomore. All right, SMU will start with the ball. It is the same starting 5 on the floor for the Mustangs. Moore, Morera, Nick Moore, Justin Martin, and Sterling Brown.
Couple of Indiana natives, Justin Martin and Nick Moore.
And Marrera can't handle the pass. It stays with SMU. Justin Martin had it knocked away. Indiana basketball.
Quick shot in transition. And a long rebound leads to a run out. Martin is fouled. That's a veteran play right there to go to the free throw line and get some cheap points going for the Mustangs. Let's take a look at the halftime numbers. Indiana, 18 three-pointers taken. They made seven of them.
Well, you see this 2-for-10 right now for SMU. The previous play, Martin had a jump shot in the corner, but he turned it down, tried to force it to get it closer. And when you don't take those kind of shots, it puts you in bad position defensively. So advantage, of course, goes to Indiana from a three-point shooting perspective. But SMU, when they're open, they got to step up with confidence, knowing that they can knock down some of those shots.
Justin Martin makes the first. He'll have another. Justin Martin from Lawrence North, same high school as Greg Oden, Mike Conley, Eric Montross back in the day. Eric Montross. He was actually an eighth grader.
Who I played with.
You played with Montross.
Montross, yeah. We played, both played for Larry Brown.
Oh, good stuff. Stick back. Good. Aggressive play. Sterling Brown makes this a two-point game. Johnson, Mascara, Perea, Farrell, Williams, and Blackman, the five on the floor. Interesting to note that Williams is on the floor early here in the second half after waiting until about the 15-minute mark to come in the game for the first time in the first half.
It's amazing. You know, you talk to coaches when they have to insert new people in the lineup. Well, I don't know how many minutes it depends on the floor. But when you need that player really to play well and he responds, you put him in the starting lineup in second half.
Nick Zeislav has three fouls. That could be a significant issue as we play this second half. Shot clock down to three. Blackman notices. He'll have to fire. Wild shot. And that'll be a shot clock violation.
Excellent defense that time by SMU, forcing Indiana to stay 2 or 3 feet above where they wanted to be in the attack zone. Now SMU, you get back in the game, you get a stop. Can you capitalize that on the offensive end and go to your bread and butter, which is getting the ball inside?
Both Moore doing it. Oh, man, inside. This is what we're talking about. Yannick Morera only played 7 first-half minutes. Didn't have any fouls, but that's what he can do. Now has 6 points.
But once again, Indiana not playing the pick-and-roll according to the scouting report, which is pushing it, forcing it to the baseline.
Offensive rebound. Blackman gets it back. You always got to hound him. And a traveling violation on Morera.
What's worked well for SMU has been the pick and roll when you clear out the strong side corner. Indiana right now not making the adjustment. And knowing Larry Brown from the professional level, you continue to run a play until they stop. And then when they stop it, you make an adjustment to see if they make an adjustment, Indiana, to the adjustment you made.
Nick Moore called for grabbing Yogi Ferrell. Nick Moore now has 3 personal fouls.
And that's huge because Nick Moore is the catalyst of this SMU offense. He has to play smart right now, in particular when he's guarding Yogi Ferrell.
And a foul inside, this one on Morera. Yogi Ferrell is doing a good job of drawing fouls on this possession alone. First foul on Morera.
And keep your eye on the pace of play right now for SMU. Nick Moore out of the game. Manuel in. It's a different kind of rhythm when he handles the basketball compared to Moore.
Blackman inside, blocked away by Manuel. What a luxury it is to have a 6'5 point guard like Manuel who can help out on defense. 38-38 tie. Johnson. There's been some ugly misses here in the second half for the Hoosiers. Morera
up and under. Can't get it to fall. Offensive rebound, stick back, Sterling Brown.
Reminiscent of what we saw earlier. Offensive rebounds, able to get it back in. Got away from that, but now SMU concentrating on pounding the ball inside. Pounding the ball, force Indiana to have to guard inside multiple times. Advantage SMU.
Free throw jumper Johnson, wide left. Rebound of traffic, Ben Moore. Three on three. Martin. And the lead is back up to five for the Mustangs.
Well, in rhythm, Mark able to catch it without thinking about it. Not turning down the shot, trying to get it closer. That's a very high percentage shot. Even if you miss, I think you have the bigs inside that can get an offensive rebound.
Good start to the second half for SMU. A 10-0 run. Johnson takes his time, gets inside, and finishes nicely.
Excellent hesitation as he Johnson got in the lane. The defenders for SMU thought he was going to pick up his dribble, but he continued to get forward and ultimately got to the basket, was able to finish over the outstretched arms of the big guys down low for SMU.
Knocked away by Williams, still very active like he was in the first half. Moore doesn't get it to fall, gets it back, stripped away, and finally Blackman pulls it away. Farrell, and a foul gone for the rebound call on Troy Williams. Timeout on the floor. SMU on the road there on top of Indiana by three. They're long, they're athletic, and they're in charge right now.
Welcome back as the SMU Mustangs have been able to mount a run in the second half to take a three-point lead. But I want you to take a look here at defense. Two particular players, especially Sterling here. On the initial post pass, Barrera's in good position. But once you give up baseline, now you have to help Troy Williams. Sterling gets inside. This is why this SMU team was a very good offensive rebounding team. As a defensive player for Indiana, you can't give up position. Because as soon as you get beat, you cause your teammates to have to help, and that's where the size and athleticism of SMU takes over and has an advantage.
SMU with the lead in the basketball. Over the years, SMU has actually won two out of the three games against Indiana, but the most recent game was back in 1978. It's been a while.
Well, it's no fluke that this SMU team is competitive and playing right now. You have a plethora of talent across the line and on the bench. It's just a matter, can they put 40 minutes together and win in a hostile environment like Assembly Hall?
Little floater goes in. Nice second half for Sterling Brown. Now up 7 points. Younger brother of former Big Tenor, Shannon Brown, played for Tom Izzo at Michigan State.
Hops.
Hops. And Shannon Brown was a lot shorter.
But
and then his brother Sterling, he's only about 6'3", but he could leap out the gym.
Yeah, and had a motor, too, had added to play with an attitude. I mean, that Michigan State tough, rugged guard developed his game as he, you know, got more mature in regards to his years at Michigan State, and actually had a long NBA career, too.
There's Sterling Brown. There's something about that Brown last name. It was Shannon Brown, high school teammates with D. Brown, who went on and did wonderful things in Champaign with Illinois. And now along comes Sterling. First free throw is good. That's a right-handed free throw for Stanford Robinson. Left-handed player a year ago, now shooting with the right hand. Missed a free throw in the first half. Look at that. That's wonderful.
Mentally, if you feel good, go with it. You know?
Lead is 3 for SMU. Those are the first 2 points on the season for Stanford Robinson.
A little 1-3-1 zone right here, which is a smart play because you want to force SMU to shoot it, but you can't allow those straight passes inside. We talked about it earlier in the first half. If you're going to play zone, you better be active. If not, SMU has shown that they can pick you apart and get easy interior baskets.
12 points now for Ben Moore. Robinson gets a screen. Wraparound pass of beauty. Sophomore to sophomore, Robinson finds Williams.
Excellent penetration, but excellent decision that time by Stanford Robinson.
Hoosiers just daring Manuel to shoot. This is Moore, a whistle before the shot, and it's going to go against SMU. 3-second violation. The Big Ten Digital Network is now BTN Plus. Available on BTN to go. Subscribe to BTN Plus and gain access to hundreds of non-televised games, and then enjoy them on more platforms wherever you are. Get BTN Plus now, available on BTN to go. Blackman, Farrell, Robinson, Williams, and Mascara Perea, the five on the floor for Indiana. Along the baseline, good finish, Mascara Perea. 1-point game. That was the first bucket for Mascara Perea. Ben Moore takes his time with a left hand. Comes up empty, Indiana ball.
We always talk about Yogi Ferrer's ability to score, but right here, the decision to make the pocket bounce pass inside instead of where the long arms of Moreira was at allowed Pereira to actually catch and finish. Maturity.
It's early in the year and different teams, but Tom Crean seems a little bit more... a little more relaxed than in years past. I haven't
you
seen.
Think?
Well, is that a good or a bad thing? It just doesn't look. He's always full of energy, but he looks calm.
That's all I'm saying.
We'll see how long it lasts. Yogi Ferrell misses the jumper. Keith Frazier back into the game. Long pass and nothing Ben Moore could do except for save it to Indiana.
And if he catches that, how is he going to be able to finish?
14 turnovers on the Mustangs. Williams hangs and is fouled. He'll go to the free throw line with a chance to give Indiana the lead.
The thought process for Moore, Nick Moore, was there, but he put his teammate in a bad position. And again, because you were in transition, SMU, you had three or four guys running towards their basket. Now you're not able to get back after the turnover. Those are the type of decisions that you expect your point guard to be better at.
Robert Johnson, Max Holtzel into the game. Yogi Ferrell and Hunter Mascara Perea head to the bench.
And I want to give Yogi a lot of credit because at this point last year, I think he would have been more offensively minded to probably take more shots. But because I think he feels more comfortable with his surrounding cast. Now, he doesn't force the situation as much. He feels more confident that he has the players around him that can make plays happen.
Jumper good. Keith Frazier off the bench. 7 points now. Blackman's been quiet in the second half. 8 minutes into it. Robinson bottled up. Has to throw it up with his left hand. And that one off the mark. And a foul in the backcourt called on Blackman. Second foul on the freshman from Fort Wayne. Timeout on the floor. This one shaping up to be a real good one. We've got 11:48 remaining, and it's a 4-point lead for SMU. Welcome back, everyone. Top three now in Indiana for 7 years. These are the freshmen that have started on opening days. So Tom Pritchard, Verdell Jones, Christian Watford in the mix. Cody Zeller, 2011. Yogi Ferrell in 2012. And last year, Noah Vonleh, Troy Williams. And this year, a pair of freshmen open the backcourt. James Blackman and Robert Johnson.
The guy on that list that I wish things would have turned out better as Maurice Creer. Because you saw at the beginning when his freshman year, he really came out and played extremely well, but then he had those injuries that just plagued him. And even when he attempted to come back when he came, it wasn't the same. You saw the potential, but one thing I say about him, his attitude, about playing the game with his teammates, coming to practice, it never changed. Actually, it got better. He felt he could help his team probably mentally by fighting the way he did, but not able to play on the court.
Jim, we saw that a moment ago, the roster makeup. No seniors on this year's team. Is that a worry spot for you?
Not the way college basketball is today. It depends on your leadership. We have good leadership, I think, with Yogi Ferrell. It's the growth of, I think, Robinson and Williams that helped these young players along. But you do have to have credence if you look at a Wisconsin.
Mm-hmm.
3-4 seniors right there in that starting lineup. That gives you a little stability there, maturity-wise.
That last fall on Cannon Cunningham. Indiana down 4. Little weave up high, leaves Hutzel open from deep. And a foul going for the rebound, called on Indiana, Troy Williams.
Outstanding. It was a good look that time by Hutzel. Indiana running their weave offense on the perimeter. Real active, got the shot they wanted, unfortunately. Not able to knock it down, but the coach here to take that, because that's the play that drew up out of timeout, and they got the kind of shot that they were looking for.
Let's see if Troy Williams will stay in the game. That was his third personal foul.
And Coach Green may have to get him out of here because he plays with a lot of energy, and it's easy for him to pick up his
Nick
fourth
Moore. Threw it off the foot of Troy Williams. Blackman, great transition layup.
Well, did you see how Blackman pushed the ball out in front? That allowed him to get his speed up, knowing he had two defenders on his side. So it was really almost like he took two dribbles from the time that he was able to pick up the loose ball.
So well coached, his dad, a wonderful high school player and college player, James Blackman Sr., obviously coaching him up and telling him the right way to play the basketball game.
Oh, keep your eye on it. And it's a little thing right here, okay? Good footwork soccer, but by pushing the ball out in front, now you allow yourself to gather more speed. Now, if he doesn't do that, if you watch the defenders, they're right next to him. So maybe he doesn't have a clear lane or have his shoulder in front of his defenders to finish. It's little things like that that make this young man special.
Just a freshman, but he's played a ton of basketball over the years in high-level competition. Frazier left alone. Indiana's got the ball, chance to tie it or take the lead. Along the baseline, Mascara Perea dribbling on the baseline. That's a turnover, a rare turnover for Indiana. Just their sixth, but a missed opportunity. Nick Moore from Winona Lake, Indiana, crosses the timeline. Good pass inside. Too hot to handle. Low Cunningham would have had a dunk. 16 turnovers for SMU.
And how many of them are unforced turnovers? They had maybe four or five charges in the first half. Some passes that are errant. You give Indiana credit, but a lot of it has to do with their lack of execution and ball handling from the Mustangs.
Two-pointer for Robert Johnson. We're tied at 50. Both the first half and the second half, almost carbon copies. SMU gets out to a big lead, and then Indiana fights back. Wild shot by Moore, offensive rebound. Sterling Brown gives you just what you need.
Well, he was able to gather himself after he was able to get the offensive rebound.
Blackman. Foul called on Brown.
Eric, rhythm timing allows you to spot up and hit shots. That time, Johnson steps into an easy shot, but off the dribble, the little hesitation that time by James Blackman freezes his defenders, allowing him to create a little bit more space to get that beautiful jump shot up.
And that was the fourth foul on Sterling Brown. Brown and Nick Moore have to go to the bench.
Blackman. Mascara Perea grabbed on the head.
Two free throws for the junior.
Well, baseline action here. Both players not able to communicate. Cunningham anticipating that Yogi Ferrell is going to continue with his dribble. Jumps out. But again, it's his fault. But where was the weak side help from SMU?
Oscar Perea just 5 for 12 at the free throw line on the year. Zeislaw back in the game, spelling Blackman, who's got a game high 19 points. Ryan Manuel initiates the offense. Morera back in.
Manuel, wow! Oh my. And an offensive foul.
Did they call an offensive foul? Larry Brown can't believe it. Ryan Manuel. Take it away. Indiana still on top. It's been a fun one so far. Indiana on top of SMU by a pair. Indiana's still on top because of a call a moment ago on Ryan Manuel, an offensive foul.
Well, Pereira was in position, feet anchored to the ground. I know my former teammate Ricky Dudley for SMU is not going to like me saying, but looked like a pretty good call.
Yeah, it looked like a good call.
Yes.
Oscar Pereira was set. And a three ball, Colin Hartman!
And Eric, it's funny how momentum changes. If that counts as a three-point play, the momentum swings toward SMU. You take a charge, take that highlight away, come out of a timeout and knock down a three.
Yannick Morera out to Manuel. 7 minutes of change remaining. Indiana trying to hand SMU their second loss on the week. 22nd ranked team of the country. And Frazier up in the air, no place to go, throws it out of bounds.
Well, indecisive, and actually the possession itself was very indecisive, but excellent ball movement. Again, Yogi Ferrell, find your teammate, make the extra pass, knowing that Hartman was in the corner, wide open. Again, momentum swings. You felt it in the crowd. You come out to timeout. You execute the play. And that's the difference you're seeing with this Indiana team now. When a play is called, they're able to execute. Even if they may miss the shot, they're getting the execution down.
Johnson walled off. Zeislaw finds Ferrell. Corner jumper. And it'll stay with the Hoosiers. Zeislaw. Lead of the evening, Nick Zeislaw. How do you do? Basketball on BTN is presented by April Air. Feel good inside. And brought to you in part by State Farm. It pays to double check. Talk to your agent today. Welcome back to Assembly Hall, Indiana, on top of SMU by 8. Last year, people sometimes wondering where the outside shooting was for the Hoosiers. I don't think this year that's going to be a problem.
Well, you can spread it around a little bit, whether that's Farrell, Zeisloff, Hartman, Blackman, Johnson. Now the remaining piece is trying to secure just something inside, because you have to have something to offset that when you're not making jump shots. I think Troy Williams gives you a slasher that can get in the paint.
SMU back to their original starting lineup, trying to get back into this game. Down by 8. Nick Moore gets a screen from Ben Moore. Doesn't use it. Shot clock down to 4. Nick Moore's going to have to fire. Oh, my! This guy's nails. Larry Brown loves him. 11 points for the junior from Winona Lake, Indiana.
And that's why it's so important that these last 6 minutes, 5.5, that he's on the floor navigating, choreographing this SMU offense, because he's hit some big shots in the past. Okay, he's not afraid of the moment right here. Calm under pressure. Didn't panic. He knew what he wanted out of it. And that's what you get from a tough-nosed individual like Nick Moore.
No secret, he wanted to play here in Indiana. There was no room. Had to go to Illinois State, now transferring to SMU. Moreira. Good footwork. Result not to his liking. Rebounded in traffic by Zeisloff. Minutes to play. Farrell, the lead. Zeisloff. 10 points for Zeisloff. And a block from behind. Finally, something goes. Ben Moore dips it in.
Well, two very good plays on both ends. One, you clear it out up top for Yogi Farrell to penetrate, had the advantage, makes the play, then inside to Moreira, doesn't get the basket, but you're able to get a cleanup on the offensive boards.
Zeisloff was open. He waited for the defender. Hartman. And a foul going for the rebound called on Mascara Perea.
May not like it, but if you watch Perea right here, grabs the inside arm. Of Moreira. So it was a good call. Again, the fans are enthusiastic, I understand, but it was a foul.
Troy Williams back in. Mascara Perea to the bench along with Hartman. Also new to the floor. Blackman checking in.
And take a look, a little smaller lineup right now for Indiana. Coach Brown adjust to that as well. You know, he has to be able to guard on the opposite end of the court.
Nick Moore, little floater. Lots to like about his game.
And that's what happens when you take out Hanna Pereira inside. Now Nick Moore has the ability or the guards to get to the basket without someone imposing inside trying to block shots.
Lead is 4 for the Hoosiers. Zeisloff. Offensive rebound, Troy Williams again. Dumped down. There's a mismatch, a significant one. 6'10 Cunningham had Farrell checking him. We'll have free throws when we come back. Indiana playing real well on offense. The three ball becoming a regularity for Zeisloff. Spokane on top of SMU by 4. Time for tonight's Country Mark on the Mark, and let's talk about the three-pointers made by the Indiana Hoosiers.
So Indiana right now 11 for 30. But here's the thing. They're in rhythm. They understand you're a guard-oriented team, so you have to knock down jump shots. And when you can spread the floor with three or four shooters, now the defense is hard to react. Who do I leave open? Who do I check off on? The guy dribbles down the lane. Now am I hesitant to help as much because the three-pointer. Now, SMU is dominating in the paint 30 and 17, but to offset that, Indiana knocking down threes, but also taking care of the basketball.
And Larry Brown's club still with a chance. This is going to be a one-on-one situation for Cannon Cunningham, who is a good free throw shooting big man. Cunningham from Arlington, Texas. On the year, he is now 9 for 11 at the line. Now here at winning time, Troy Williams, Yogi Ferrell, Honor Mascara Perea, James Blackman, and Robert Johnson, the five on the floor for Indiana. Tough shot, ball was knocked away on the way up. They're going to say that Cunningham got Williams on the wrist, and Williams will shoot a pair, missed a pair a moment ago at the free throw line.
And that time Cunningham got caught in between. Excellent position that time, help on the baseline. But once you swipe down a little bit, and Troy Williams, again, being aggressive. Now, that was going to be a tough shot to make. But Cunningham, by swiping down at the end, kind of he basically bailed Troy Williams out from a tough shot.
11 points in the first game of the season for Troy Williams.
Let's see in his last 3 minutes if SMU is patient enough to allow the offense to work, to see if they can get back to getting the basketball inside, using athleticism to their advantage. Never mind.
Long two-pointer missed by Nick Moore.
Nick Moore had something else on his mind.
Extra pass into the corner. And Blackman's fouled. Three throws for James Blackman.
And I believe that's the second foul that SMU committed when the Indiana player is shooting a three-pointer. Again, and it goes back to the fundamentals. See, you close out, you're scrambling right now, and that's just out of control. You know, you close out under control, and you contest the shot. Not being in position, though, Eric, at the beginning of the possession, caused that foul.
Pretty stroke at the free throw line for Blackman. That ball didn't touch any rim. What do you expect? Born and raised here in the Hoosier State. 6'1 guard, 6'4 guard. Free throws are going to be close to automatic.
Go get your money. I mean, that's what it's there for, the free throw line when you stroke it. I used to love to get to the free throw line. I know from a scoring average perspective, you know, you get to the free throw line, hey, and especially for a guard. I always say guard should be mid-70s to 80s. No doubt. If you're a shooter, that's where you should be free throw percentage.
Blackman now 13 out of 15 on the year. Time running out for SMU, down by a half dozen. Cunningham, half hook. Pretty move.
Not that hard. The game is a little simple. Sometimes we as basketball players make it tougher. If you can get deep post position, why not continue to go to it?
Minutes left to play. Ferrell. Three more. And a reach-in foul on the freshman Johnson. Freshman mistake that Tom Crean will have to live with.
Well, right here on Ferrell's three-pointer, this was excellent defense. Why overhelp? Why is Nick Moore helping on Troy Williams, who's driving to the basket, but his defender is there? Pay attention to the scouting report. You know Yogi Ferrell's going to spread out to the corner. He can knock down shots. Why overhelp? See, the attention to detail, the little things, is the mental part of the game is what's plaguing this SMU team.
Big free throw for Justin Martin. Justin Martin could have played anywhere in the country. He's already graduated from Xavier. He'll always have that diploma in his house. But he said, you know what? I've got one last year of college basketball, and I want to do it with Larry Brown. So he's now an SMU Mustang providing leadership. Chance to make it a five-point game. Hoosier's going to work the clock, you'd imagine.
Smart. Instead of forcing up a shot right there, Yogi Ferrer understanding time and score.
Shot clock down to 8. Blackman notices. Goes one-on-one. Mustangs call timeout. 70 seconds remaining. Might as well tell you about all the things happening over the weekend on Saturday on BTN. How about this one? The Buckeyes looking to stay in the college football playoff hunt. They're going to take on Kevin Wilson's Indiana Hoosiers. Some will see Michigan State battling Rutgers. And then Maryland at Michigan. That is a 3:30 Eastern time start. And it doesn't end there. Talk about a super Saturday. More basketball. Lamar and Indiana, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by Boise State and Wisconsin. Of note, Lamar, Preston Mattingly is a 27-year-old shooting guard on that team. If the last name sounds familiar, he's Don Mattingly's son, grew up down in Evansville, played professional baseball for a number of years, and said, you know what, give hoops a try. So he's a 27-year-old sophomore who will come into this building playing for Lamar.
Talking to Coach Trini, he talked about Don Mattingly, one of his two favorite baseball players.
Yeah.
That he never had a chance to meet him, but has a lot of autographed memorabilia from him. So that'll be interesting, you know.
Yeah.
It's funny how a player like that, baseball, and you got drafted in baseball, but ends up playing basketball at a later age.
It's hard to do.
Very hard to do.
Don Mattingly is a big-time Hoosier fan. I would bet that he'll be in attendance on Saturday. Brown goes baseline, circus move. Special player out of Maywood, Illinois. Quick timeout. It is a four-point game.
And Larry Brown, master of extending the game. Okay, out of the timeout, that time, Johnson a little lackadaisical in his defensive position, gave up baseline, but once again, the Indiana defense late in rotation, able to give it up. And Larry Brown, timeout quickly, get his defense set. And you have a minute left, but Larry Brown is going to extend this game, so Indiana has to be fully engaged here.
SMU on the road shooting 57%. That's 20 percentage points better than Indiana, yet they're trailing. Why?
Turnovers. It's different when you're on the road. One thing you have to do, you can't turn the basketball over. You have to keep the home team off the free throw line. Right now, too many turnovers for SMU. And then from a free throw disparity perspective, it's all in favor of Indiana.
19 turnovers.
Right.
Larry Brown, a former point guard for Dean Smith, he's tearing his guts out.
Well, that's why he's so hard, and he expects a lot more out of his point guard because he played the position.
Expected a lot out of Allen Iverson back in the day.
Yeah, I was there. They had a lot of run-ins, so to speak.
Larry Brown got a lot out of Allen Iverson. That was a good relationship for both at the end of the day.
Yes.
Hoosiers playing keep away. Blackman, creative dribbling, trying to get away from Manuel. Shot clock down to 8. Yogi Ferrell going to go to work on Nick Moore. Yogi gets inside. Tough shot. Rims out. Finally corralled by SMU. They're down by 4. They got to hurry. Someone's going to have to put one up there. Nick Moore, 3 ball. Rebounded by Blackman. He hits the deck, and what do we have? It'll be a foul on the Mustangs.
The difference is with Indiana, you have Johnson, Blackman, or Yogi Ferrell in that situation that can make a play. For SMU, Manuel had it, but really wasn't comfortable and was looking for Nick Moore, so you wasted valuable time trying to get that type of shot. And that's the value of having multiple players that can really create for you offensively.
Blackman at the free throw line. Two-shot foul. They got the right guy at the free throw line. There's a proud papa, James Blackman Sr. He's actually one that got away. He was second to Steve Alford in the 1983 Mr. Basketball. And he went out of state. He went and played for the Kentucky Wildcats. Joe B. Hall,
B. Hall
came into Marion, Indiana and said, why don't you play for me?
Well, he may not have been able to play here, or chose not to, but his son is here, which is good for this program, for the state. Athletic player back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
Proud father. And I know he's more nervous, trust me, watching his son play than when he played.
Yeah, doesn't need to be nervous. This kid is pretty darn good at a young age. 22 points, 7 rebounds. He's done it from behind the arc as per usual, shooting at a 50% clip. Robert Johnson, 0 for 6 from behind the arc. A little bit of a surprise. Had been 4 for 6 shooting threes coming into this one, but the competition level radically different than Texas Southern and Mississippi Valley State.
It also speaks volumes to have a father who has played at a high level. I believe that's why you see Blackman with the poise that he possesses.
Hoosier fans are going to feel real comfortable with Blackman at the free throw line in years to come. Transition three-pointer is good. No, it's a long two by Moore. And a stoppage of the clock. That is the last timeout for SMU. 2.8 remaining. And a teaching moment right now for Larry Brown. His team all but out of it, down by 4.
Out of it, but a learning lesson for this SMU team that you got to play a complete game. We did a lot of things well, Larry Brown is going to tell his team after the game. But when Indiana turned up the pressure, SMU couldn't respond. They held leads, they lost leads. But if you want to play big-time basketball and you want to win on the road, you got to figure out ways to maintain that continuity that got you the lead.
And folks, I've been waiting all night long to give you this pearl. Larry Brown and my partner Jim Jackson, if you're coming up with a travel log of NBA cities, all you need to do is consult these two. Jim, you played for 12 different NBA teams. Larry Brown coached 9 different teams. Between the two of you, 21 different franchises employed you guys.
Unbelievable. You know the beautiful thing about that? That was 21 different checks.
That's right.
That kept coming. So
they're going to like just make sure that that was indeed a 2. It looked like Ben Moore's foot was on the line, and I don't know if we're going to get a better look. You see Troy Williams. Here we go. On the floor is called a 2.
Yeah, it looks like that right foot turned in. From this angle, it's really tough to see because of Williams. I'm right there.
Now, they called it originally a 2, and I'm not sure that there's going to be anything that's going to be able to overturn that. Maybe. Oh, what a wonderful picture there.
Yeah, there it is. Two ball.
Man, that's perfect. Absolutely the perfect angle you needed. And that would have been big. If that had been a 3, my goodness, that would have made it a 1-possession game.
Yeah, since we're on the air right now, I'm gonna let it go and apologize to Larry. Held a grudge. He traded me.
Uh-oh.
He said he's going to trade me to a playoff team. San Antonio was in the mix. Traded me to Golden State.
But there's a paycheck there.
Oh, yeah, it was.
And Blackman, that's what scores do.
But he got.
That's what scores do. End of the game, they grab the ball and they go to the free throw line.
Listen, let me tell you something. You'd be amazed how easy you can get open when you really want to. Because when you're a shooter and want to get to the free throw line, you weren't going to deny me the ball to get to the free throw line. I was going to figure out a way to get open. That's what Blackman did right there. And is it selfish?
It's not. He's going to make his 2 free throws.
But his teammates understand that, too, though, and they look for him.
I think the best competition on this team is going to be
who shoots the technical fouls.
Oh, yeah.
You got Blackman, you got Zeisloft, you got Farrell, who did it last year.
I think it'd be Farrell, unless he's not in the game.
I put Blackman on.
No, they'll adhere to the leadership. Not Yogi goes through a shooting slump, yeah, but no.
This will be the final shot of the game, and it doesn't count. Take it away, Nick Moore. After the buzzer, congratulations, Tom Crean and the Indiana Hoosiers. They survive. You ask me, this is what you're looking for, non-conference. A well-played game, two teams equally matched, a tough battle, and in the end, the Hoosiers, they can feel really good about this win against the 22nd-ranked team in the country. 74-68 the final. Indiana, they stay perfect. They are now 3-0 on the year. Next up, they will take on Lamar on Saturday. A big reason why Indiana survived tonight was because of the freshman. James Blackman, early on, taking it to the rack. Showed off a little bit of a mid-range game as well. And then the barrage from behind the arc. In total, 5 3-pointers made for James Blackman. And at the end, final couple of minutes, he was the guy that everyone wanted at the free throw line. And he did not disappoint. A perfect 7 for 7 at the free throw line for the 19-year-old from Fort Wayne. So, a lot to smile about. We're going to get a chance to talk to head coach Tom Crean with his thoughts. Jim, take it away.
Coach Crean got off to a slow start. What changed in the middle of that first half?
Well, we weren't attacking the rim. 19 of our first jump shots in the first half came off never touching the paint. We can't play that way. But we got much better inside of the first half and got things running. And the ball's got to get in the lane. We're going to shoot jumpers, but it's got to touch the paint.
Well, how much of a factor you talk about energy and effort was Troy Williams when he entered the game?
Oh, we knew he was going to be full of energy. And he was trying to get it right there. But he's got a lot of edge to him. And he made some big plays for us. Stan made some big plays. Emmett's time will come, but guys like this and guys like Blackman stepped up here and did some fantastic things. We're young, but we got some hungry guys that are very serious-minded about getting better.
Well, you've always kept and surrounded this team with outstanding freshmen. This young man has a poise beyond his years. Talk a little bit about that.
Well, the same. James and Rob, they become such good friends, even though they really didn't know each other before we recruited them, because they both have the same mindset. It's serious. It's hard work. They don't take themselves too serious with their talent, but they take their games extremely serious. They've been well-coached, well-raised, and they represent Indiana in a great way.
Thanks a lot, Coach. James, congratulations on a great game for you. It seems like you kind of pick and choose when you tend to get aggressive. Is that something that subconsciously you do? Or is that something the coaching staff talks about?
Well, I think I grew up doing that. But coming here, he's a great coach. He tells me when to look for my shot and when not to. But my teammates were so unselfish this game, they kept finding me.
This SMU team was tough. What changed for you guys?
It just changed. We just tried to get him tired and wear him out because we had a lot of quick guards. They were way bigger than us, but we had to play way scrappy.
Thanks a lot. Congratulations on the win. You got it.
Well, a fun night here on a Thursday here in Bloomington, Indiana. Indiana, they are challenged, but at the end, they pick up a quality win that they will really smile about at the end of the season. Final score, one final time, 74-68, Indiana on top of SMU. Coming up next on BTN, it's Big Ten Football and Beyond. For my partner, Jim Jackson, and our entire BTN crew, I'm Eric Collins, and so long, this has been an exclusive presentation of the Big Ten Network.